Hello everyone, welcome to New York Jazz Workshop. My name is Vito Lesczak and I would like to demonstrate today a piece for three drums that was derived from a monk tune, straight note chaser, and monk's piano solo on that particular tune. I'm always looking for some melodic ways to play drum solos, so I'm always looking for instrumental solos to learn on the drums. Sometimes as drummers, we, you know, our approach is very often rudiment oriented or has a lot of coordination exercises in there, but it's also very helpful and interesting to try to think on the drums like an instrument would think, like a saxophone or a piano would think. So in this particular tune, Straight Note Chaser, I worked with, I learned the melody on the drums, on the snare drum, and then I learned monk solo on the snare drum. And to begin with, I would like to just demonstrate that part of it. Monk solo and the melody on Straight Note Chaser. Now you heard the piece just being played on the snare drum, and then you can orchestrate this around the drums, incorporating all the different pieces of the drums. And while I was doing this, one interesting aspect, I noticed how some of those phrases remind me completely of Max Roach phrases, stuff he would play on the drums. And it became really clear to me how drummers moved away from the more rudimentary approach in the 40s and tried to apply more a melodic approach on the drums. It really came from trying to copy those instrumentalists. You know, I'm not sure how consciously he did that, but you can hear him, you know, sounding, playing like Charlie Parker phrases and monk phrases, and when you hear this monk solo being translated on the drums, I think you can hear how this approach then was incorporated into jazz drumming. So let me demonstrate now. I'm going to play actually not the melody but just the two choruses of monk solo on the whole drum set. After using all this material on the snare and on the whole drum set, I had this idea to combine it into a piece for three drums, where the parts of the melodies get divided up, drummers get individual solo space, and then the monk solo adapted for the drums becomes a unison part for all three drums. The idea was just to add another layer of orchestration, because you can play different parts of the drums at different times than in a melody, those parts start to sound slightly different than if it's just played by one instrument. Also, just to, you know, give drummers a possibility to work on something together, to have a piece that could be actually played by three drums, by three jazz drums. So we recorded, I can't record this at the same time, so we recorded those pieces on top of each other and then put overlaid those. But I would like just to present this piece now to you with three drums. We have the melody, first two choruses of the melody broken up between three drums, then some drums take a solo while the other drums accompany, and then we have some the unison parts with the monk solo, and then at the end we come back with the melody, which is divided up between the three drums. So I hope you enjoy, and maybe even you give it a try. You can always check in with me for the parts. I'd be happy to give them to you. So that was the piece. I'm curious to actually what you thought. You can, why don't you let me know? Give me some feedback on the piece. Also, if you're interested, I actually have a bunch of those pieces. You know, you could maybe join one of our classes at New York Jazz Workshop, and we could work on those together. Check out the website, newyorkjazzworkshop.com. And let me know what you think.